Hey everyone, it's Muriel. So I'm here with a project share. I wanted to share with you a banner, a spooky banner that I created. And I'm going to be placing this above my fireplace. A lot of times I make projects and for the holiday and I kind of decorate my cubicle at work. But this time I thought I would keep this one home and decorate for myself. I think, you know, just because the kids are gone doesn't mean that you have to stop decorating your home for the holiday. So let me show you the paper collection that I used to create this banner. I am using the Wicked collection by My Mind's Eye, and it goes back several years. And this particular pack is the party elements. So everything in this kit you could use to decorate your home, your table, whatever, for a Halloween party. There are banners, there are beverage labels, there are party hats, treat boxes, invitations, you name it. So I took advantage of this and I used some of the beverage labels to create a fishtail banner on my banner, and I also used some of the cupcake toppers to use for some dimensions, and I used all of the stickers and dimensional stickers that I had left. So really fun paper pad. In the back of it there is lots of 12 by 12 sheets that you could use for, you know, making cards or whatever, but the beginning of the pad there's the invitations, lots of invitations, at least 12. And there are the brim for the party hat. So really fun. I enjoyed using this for my banner. And I think that if there is a Halloween little gathering in the office this year, I think I'm gonna pull this out, because you can see how you can make a quick banner using the words here. There's Halloween and trick or treat that you can just put together, 1, 2, 3. So that's what I used on this. I started out by using this orange burlap triangle banner that was gifted to me by Anna Yana. She gave me this a couple of years ago, and I knew that I would be using it for a Halloween banner, but I needed to back it with some medium weight chipboard, so that's what I did. I also used a doily. This is a kind of like a chipboard doily. I picked these up at Marshall's. They're purpose for something else, but I wanted something sturdy to put my ribbon around. I'm using some purple ribbon that I, a wired ribbon from Costco. And so I use these to give it some backing. And many of the stickers I used from the collection, as well as all of the, I didn't use any of that, all of the dimensional stickers. I can kind of throw this away now. And the chipboard stickers. I happen to have two sets. So they're all gone, so I'm so happy with that. So let me show you my banner. It says the word spooky. And I'll just show you each letter here. So you can see where I used some chipboard here, the back of the banner, and I'm using this really pretty black lace around the edge, all three sides of the banner. And this lace I bought from a D-Stash from Marissa, and I think I have some left. I was trying to sell it, but it is really pretty and dainty. I love the way the edges look around the banner. So I covered the center of it with the doily. You can see the chipboard is back there. I did some gathering of some purple ribbon and then layered a green doily, and there's the cake topper there, and then I have the glitter letters. I don't know where I got those from, but those are, they were perfect. I looked at my stash and they're the perfect size and they're glittered, so they really complemented the banner. And then I just have a couple of the dimensional stickers throughout. I mean, I was just using it just to get rid of. And at the bottom here, I did some layering. You can see this fishtail banner from the beverage label. And then I put a dimensional sticker. At the bottom here, I created some dangles. That is a bead, black bead, a rondelle, square rondelle, and then a skeleton head. And I have it hanging on a garment pin. And these skeleton heads were gifted to me by Ana Yanez in a swap. So P looks the same way. You can see it's all kind of just using up all the stickers, all of the dimensional stickers. So I am so happy how it came out, how it turned out. It really is. The purple around the doily here really pops, and the green also. So it was fun to do. I'm glad it's done. I'm going to take it and hang it up downstairs and take a picture and show my daughter that just because she's gone doesn't mean that mama is not still decorating the house. So thank you guys for watching. Leave some comments down below. Again, this is a spooky banner using the Wicked collection from My Mind's Eye. Thanks again for watching. Bye now.